Peace be on you all. Hello everyone, this is Mohammed Amir from Diazonic Labs. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this particular video, we'll be learning about Python programming language. I'm gonna begin with the basic installation process of Python language. So now, to begin with Python, we all know that Python is the most commonly used language in the world. It has got many applications, be it web development or app development, game development, be it data science, machine learning. So the applications of Python programming are tremendous. With that being said, I'm gonna start with the basic installation tutorial first. We will check whether the Python programming language is installed in our laptop or not. How do you check that? The most simplest manner what you can check is just go to start menu and type here cmd. When you type cmd, one command prompt link will be open, one command prompt option will be there. Click on that, open command prompt. As you all know that command prompt is this particular black and white window. And one quick note for you to understand, you might have seen many hackers using this particular command. If you just want to, you know, give a different color to this, maybe, you know, you can change the color. See, this looks more cool, right? Yeah, so you can just type color A for changing the color of your command prompt. All right, now coming back to our Python programming language, what I want you to do is first just type the wordings Python here, and what will happen is, by default, since Python is not installed in your computer, you will get this particular output. So it says Python is not recognized as an internal or external command, operable program or batch file. So what this means is Python is not installed in your system, in your computer, or maybe Python is installed or maybe that, you know, you have not specified the path correctly. So more about path, I'm gonna talk to you later when I complete the installation of Python. Now let's understand how we can install this Python programming software. So to do that, I have to go to this particular thing of Google Chrome. Here I am gonna go to google.com first, and then inside Google I will type here Python download. Alright, when I type here Python download, I will get this link here, download Python from the first link, whatever I get here. This is the official website of Python, python.org. Let me go inside this, and when I go inside this here, I will have the option of downloading the latest version for Windows. I'm using the Windows 10 operating system. So here, this is what I get. Now, if you are using a different operating system here, it has got a lot of other support, say Linux machine or Mac OS or any other operating system machine if you are using. Now here, if I click on this, I will get the installation for a file for the latest version for Windows. I will not use the latest version of Python for my Windows. Now there is a reason which you have to understand. Python is a language which has got multiple libraries, and the most important feature of Python, or why Python is so famous, is because it has got a lot of libraries. Many developers all around the world contribute to the Python Foundation by writing their own libraries. So since we have got a lot of libraries, now what happens is whenever a latest version comes in the market, there will be a lot of problem for many libraries to be compatible with that. You know, there will be a lot of bugs and some other different errors related to the latest release. It's always preferable that you download a version prior to it. Now what does it mean? So here I am using the latest version in the market is 3.8. so what we can do is we can use a Python version 3.7. any 3.7 version would be sufficient. So from where will I find the older version of Python? All you have to do is just scroll down here. Here you'll have a option saying looking for a specific release. Yes, so here inside this you can download any of the Python version. You can check for any 3.7 version. 3.7 version should be sufficient. So I'm gonna search for 3.7.1. Okay, so 3.7.1 is here. Although you can use any Python version, not at all a problem. But then I am gonna use Python 3.7.1 because I have used it before, and I know that almost all the libraries out there will work properly for this. Right, so I will click on Python 3.7.1 here, and then when I go inside this, I will have one option. Let me just scroll down here. I will have to select one particular option to download. Again, as I had mentioned that I'm using Windows 10 as my operating system, and I'm using 64-bit operating system. So here I'll be interested in looking forward for these three particular versions. Okay, so here the first says embeddable, then you have got executable, and then you have got web-based installer. You can select any of these three, but then more specifically I will select this executable installer. Why am I doing this? Because I can install it from scratch, and also I can give that particular path thing. If you remember, here at the end we need to get Python shell opened here. So for that important reason, I will also use it's better that I use this executable installer. So let me click on this executable installer, and then see here it has started downloading, and yes, based on your internet speed, it will complete the downloading process. And now my downloading process is completed. I'll just click on this and I'll click on open. When I click on open here, okay, it's asking one security warning. Just let me click on run and then wait for some time. Yes, now this is what I get here: install Python 3.7.1 64-bit. Here you have got two options. Install now is your first option, and customized installation is your second option. Now I will be obviously clicking on install now. The main focus, what I want you to see here, the main important point which I want you to note down here is the path which is given here below. See here it says your local disk C, then you have got users as your folder, then administrator, app data, local programs, Python 37. Okay, so I want you to focus on this particular path, because we'll be going back to this particular path again and again if you want to install any new library inside your Python. Okay, now having said that, before clicking on install now, very important point is I want you to select add Python 3.72 path. Now what will happen when you do this? When you do this, what happens is all of the Python software, like imagine you want to open Python software, you can open it from any folder from your command prompt here. After the installation is done here, I'm gonna show it by typing your Python, you will get Python shell opened. So here when you click on add 3.72 path, what happens is that your Python software becomes more accessible, or it becomes, say, more global. Just to give you a comparison, you can consider if you don't give this path, your Python software will act as a local variable. That means you can open Python software only in that particular folder, and when you give the path, it is accessible to each and every folder in your computer. That means it acts as a global variable. Just to give you an analogy, okay, so the technical analogy I'm just trying to give you so that you can understand, everyone can understand what is happening here. Okay, now very important thing, just click on this path and then click on install now. When you click on install now, it will take some time to get installed all of the necessary software, executable files along with the folders will all be getting set up, and the progress bar is, you know, running. Once the progress bar is completed, you will get one particular option, not option, you will get one particular statement saying that your Python software has been installed successfully. All right, so let's wait for some time and see here. As we go on, the documentation is also given, then you have got something related to utility scripts, and everything is of 64-bit right now. One focus which I wanted to tell you is that I'm installing 64-bit software for Python here. So yes, it is installing. It takes its own time based on, again, your RAM of your computer and your CPU processor, how fast is it. It all installs everything, whatever is required for your Python launcher or for your Python software to get set up completely in your computer system. Alright, so let's wait for some time and hopefully it gets installed properly. Okay, finally see here the path was also added, and then it says setup was successful. So what it means is your Python setup is completed right now. You are ready to launch your Python ideally. Now there are two ways of launching. One way I've already told you is through command prompt. I'm going to show you both the ways and I'll tell you how to get started with the first code of Python now. Okay, so let me click on close here and let me just press Python and check whether it comes. Press enter. See here, now the moment I type Python here, it says Python 3.7.1 and then your Python shell is open right now. So this is your Python shell and I'm using Python 3.7.1 as my version. So I have got my Python shell opened here, and let me quickly do the first code by writing print of, say, always we learn hello world. Let me do here, say, hello space world. Close this, press enter, you get the output here, hello world. So this is the first Python code which we have learned till now. So this is one way of using command prompt. Now remember, please note, immediately after the installation, when you type Python, if you still get Python is not recognized as internal or external command, if you get this error, once again what you have to do is you have to close your command prompt and restart it. So just close it and then go back to your command or start menu, press command prompt and then press Python again, and then the Python shell will reopen. Okay, so sometimes you might have to restart your command prompt to make sure that everything is set up properly. And how do you exit from this shell? If you want to exit, you can type exit open and close parenthesis, and then you are out. Now you are out in the command line interface. And even after doing this, if still you are getting that error, Python is not recognized, that means you might have not followed my steps properly, or else maybe the setup path for your path variable is not declared properly, the environment path variable is not declared properly. I will be discussing how to set up your environment path manually in the upcoming video as well. So I had already told you that there's one more way of opening the Python shell. How you can do that is just go to start menu and type here Python. You will get now two Python apps. One is Python 3.7. Directly it opens the Python shell. Let me open and show it for you. This is my Python shell. It is exactly the same thing as what I had shown here. This is one of the shell. I'll just type here hello, and yes, you get hello world printed. And there's one more software which comes by default with the Python. Let me close this and type here IDLE and then press enter. Open IDLE. It is a little bulky software, so it takes a little more time to open. So yes, this is basically white in color. Again, you get the same shell here. Now these are all the different ways wherein you can open your Python shell and you can work on it. Now when you have shell, your Python will work as an interpreted language. Okay, so you can do line by line execution of a program, of a code. If you want to execute the program as a whole, more like the compiling thing which we do, then in Python ideally you can go to file, you can create a new file and then start coding. Okay, so that is also there. All of this will be covered in the upcoming tutorial series, whatever we have. So I think so you might have understood what and all I have taught you till now. So having said that, I'm gonna sign off for this particular video. I hope that that was informative. Many more tutorial series to come related to Python series and also a lot of other technologies. If you have any interest in understanding any particular technology, do please comment down in my video. Until then, please share, like and comment on whatever doubts you have regarding this particular video. Until then, take care, goodbye, I'll see you next time.